Well, hello there. Welcome to Media Tsunami's Top 5 Favorite Christmas Gifts. We want to wish you guys a Merry Christmas, and we hope you enjoy our list.
Ho Ho 5.
To kick off my list, my number 5 is a bit of a funny story, really. I was probably about 12 or so, and SpongeBob SquarePants was a like brand new show, like fairly new. Of course, I was the right demographic for it, so my amazing sweet grandmother went out and bought me a shirt, and probably just noticed it had SpongeBob on it, not bothering to read anything else on the shirt or see exactly what was happening. So Christmas morning, little 12-year-old Matt is really excited about what he's getting from his grandmother. He opens it up, sees this gray t-shirt, pulls it out, and it is a picture of SpongeBob naked, covering his crotch with the word shrinkage above him. Now you can imagine my expression. There's a picture somewhere. I'm gonna try to get it up here for you guys so you can enjoy it as much as I did. But everybody in the room busts out laughing. I'm laughing. My grandmother's like, what's going on? We turn around, show her, and her face just, she realizes it. It was hilarious. And obviously I don't wear that shirt. It's far too small for me anyway. I don't think I still have it. Just kind of sad. I wish I could bring it to show you guys.
My number 5 is a bicycle that I got when I was quite younger. It was the first bike I ever had that didn't have the pedal brakes. It was the actual cool hand brakes. I was probably 16 or 17 when I got this bike, so it was great. No, I'm just kidding. I was actually like 8 or 9 or something like that, but it was a bicycle, and I just remember riding it down the driveway and my dad being like, okay, you don't pedal backwards to stop. Well, I tried to pedal backwards to stop and ran into a wall. That's my number 5.
My number 5, Donkey Kong 64. It is my first 64 game and is my second favorite game of all time. It is also the game me and my brother fought the most about.
My number 5 are Z-Bots. Not just any Z-Bots, like this guy, or even this guy. But instead, it was the big blue playset. I don't remember what it's called, but there's a picture of it. That thing was cool. Real cool.
Ho Ho 4!
My number 4. Hanna-Barbera's The Herculoids. The best animated show a child could ever want. Has everything from monsters to dames to rhinoceros, something like that.
My number 4 was a Band-Aid that I got after running into that wall. I went to the hospital, they patched me up, and voila, new Band-Aid.
As you can see from my number 4 pick, I have a Boba Fett helmet, and there are a few reasons why I picked this one. One of them is that if you guys have followed any of our lists that we've done, you guys know that Boba Fett is a huge fan. Love the character, think he's great, super cool. The helmet is obviously super nice. It's one of my favorite pieces in my nerdy collection. It actually does still work, so you can hear him talk. Maybe. And it actually fits, which is kind of cool. So I'm not going to keep that on there because it might be too muffled. But the main reason that I chose this one is because it's actually my wife who got this for me about 3 years ago. So 24-year-old man still getting toys, nothing wrong with that. But it's just kind of special because it's cool that she embraces my nerdiness and just kind of really plays into it. And so I thought that one was kind of fun.
Rhinoceroids? Yeah, rhinoceroids.
My real number 4 actually was not a Band-Aid. That's a terrible gift, especially from a hospital. It was actually one of those really cool Kinect roller coasters where you built it up and it was like took up half the living room, and it just like ran on its own. You could sit there all day and watch it. But that was a lot of fun to build. Had some help from my dad actually building it. And it was a good gift that my parents gave me. One of my favorites. Number four.
Number four. Micro Machines. Z-Bots were Micro Machines. Micro Machines ruled the 90s. Star Wars ruled the 90s. Micro Machines Star Wars. Number four.
Ho ho three.
My number three, now getting to the video game portion of the list, I'm out of eggnog, was a Game Boy Advance that I got at the age of somewhere between 10 and 12. Not quite sure what it was, what age I was, but it was great. It came with Super Mario Advanced, and I played that game for hours. Oh boy, eggnog!
My number three, unlike my first two, are not from my childhood. The Micro Machines Star Wars and the Z-Bots were from about 5th to 7th grade. My next one, I was a man. But it's something I longed for since the time of childdom. That's a word, right? Childdom? Childdom. And that was to go on a trip to WrestleMania. Now I know what you're thinking, WrestleMania is not during Christmas time. But my mommy and daddy, at the tender age of 31, gave me money to buy tickets to WrestleMania. Is that right side up? That's upside down. To WrestleMania. And I went, and it was a dream come true. Thanks, mom and dad. Thanks.
So for my number three pick, I actually have what is my favorite game console of all time, the Super Nintendo. So growing up, I lived really close to my uncle and my grandparents, so I'd always go over to their house and he and I would play games like Super Metroid, Donkey Kong Country, things like that were always really big hits for me. And so, but we didn't really own game consoles at that point, so I didn't really have a chance to play them on my own. And that Christmas morning, my parents were like, hey, cool, we got you something really awesome, I think you're gonna love it. And so I went in and had a Super Nintendo with Donkey Kong Country 2 and Super Mario World All-Stars. And that's really kind of the point that kickstarted my love for video games. I actually had my own way of playing one. Now I'm playing with power.
My number three. Playmobil's 1993 vintage castle with breakable escape walls, opening doors, five knights, and completely assemblage. Assembly, as some may say. There you go.
Deal with it.
I'm not saying that again.
Ho, ho, ho! Two!
John, I hate this. I don't like Christmas at all.
Christmas doesn't like you, man. Shut up and do it.
Number two, eggnog. I don't know who gave it to me, but I know it only comes out in December and sometimes in late November, but it is the gift that keeps on giving throughout the month, every day. All week.
And now it's time for my number two. And I'm gonna cheat. With two. I get to do that because I edit this show. And what we have here is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles for the NES and RC Pro-Am for the NES. And I picked these because in the year of 1988 or 89, one of those two, I got these for at the same Christmas. These were my first two games other than Super Mario Duck Hunt. And they was the bomb, yo! Continuing with the video game theme, my number two was my Xbox 360 I got. It was really great, but the problem is, my parents got me this 360 with no video games. So I had to sit on Christmas Day looking at an Xbox 360. That was the bad part of the gift. The next 7 years of Xbox, though, were pretty great.
So, number two I actually didn't bring with me. It's a little more of a serious sentimental one for me. A few years back when I was... my wife and I got married in January, so the Christmas before, we were getting ready. and everything. And my uncle sent me a present for Christmas, and I opened it up, and there was a letter that that he had actually written out for me. That said, your mammy and your granny would have wanted to be here. Unfortunately, they both passed away a few years prior. He's like, but I thought this would be cool of me, a way for them to kind of go with you. And I looked in, and it was a pair of cufflinks that he had actually gotten made for me that had one of each of them and like a picture of them. And so that was something that was really special to me, you know. Loved both of them dearly, and it was, you know, kind of a, it was a really cool gift, and one that I still really love.
Ho, ho, ho! One!
And now it's time for my ultimate number one choice. And here it is. Star Wars Trilogy. Now, I saw these movies well before I actually got them. And I would rent them from Blockbuster or whatever the local movie store was at the time, over and over and over again. But that one fateful Christmas, I tore off the bow, I ripped open the wrapping, and there it was. And my life was complete.
And finally, for my number one pick, this was part of the gift, but the actual main thing was a Game Boy Color. And one reason I really liked this one is just it was just kind of a fun one. The Christmas I got it, we had finished unwrapping presents, and we were kind of wrapping up. And my dad was like, oh, hey, there's one more gift in here. And I was like, oh, cool. He's like, it's yours. And so I went to open it and tore off the paper. It was a box. So I opened it up, and there's another box inside of it. And so I'm like, okay, what's going on here? Open up another box, and there's another box. Open it up, and it's empty. And I'm thinking, my dad's just being a punk, you know? He's just kind of silly like that. And he's like, oh, that's fun. Here's a Game Boy Color. And just kind of hands me one. I'm like, oh, that's awesome. This was, I believe, my third grade year. Pokemon had just come out, so I knew it was something that I really wanted to play. All my friends had one. And so getting that, as well as this game, was just really special. It was a fun gift from my dad, and one that I played for hours and hours. I unfortunately don't have the Game Boy Color anymore. I believe I gave it to a younger cousin of mine, but it's just one that I really look back on fondly.
And my number one Christmas gift of all time was the gift that got me into video games, a Sega Genesis that I received at the age of 5 from my father. It came with my favorite Sega Genesis game of all time as well, Vector Man. This is one of the few games my dad would ever play with me, and one of the few games that I didn't beat till I was probably 16 years old. But this game is phenomenal. You should check out our playthrough of it, where I attempt to beat it. Do I actually do it? You'll have to watch to find out. Anyway, that's my Christmas list of greatest gifts I've received of all time.
This is gross. This is what he does.
And my number one is The Gift of Literacy by Tolkien. The Hobbit, and the 50th anniversary edition of Lord of the Rings. It took me about 3 years to read it, in 2 different states, through 4 different seasons. But I finished it, and every second, except for Merry and Pippin, were excellent.
Well, that was our top 5 Christmas present list. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and we just want to tell you guys Merry Christmas from us here at Media Tsunami.
Still smiling?
Oh.
My 5. Number 1.
I said number 1.
My 5. Number 1.
You're also
you're
dripping
welcome.
Into your shirt now.
Yeah, you dripped that dog.
That's
from,
good.
From your beard.
So am I going from 1 to 5 or 5?
No, say my number 5, five Donkey Kong.
Just
my,
like he did.
My number.
Just like he did. Just like I did.
I wasn't paying attention.
Just like every episode did of you, the Nerd List did.
Did you not never listen to them?
That's why.
We should get that bad boy like up and kicking again. Just like every topic similar.
Yeah. So just my number five.
I'd do a podcast.
Yeah. My number three. My number two. My number one.
Yeah. So all right, number five.
All right.
Do a quick reordering in my head here. Okay. Okay.
That's the video cover right there.
Oh crap, it's time.
That's the most silent thing I've ever seen.
With two.
Well, that's... Get out!
You got a little farther that time.
No. I can't breathe! I'm so sorry! I'm crying!
He's really dying.
I'm crying!